How to create drive textures. I'm looking at the TV-03. That is today's video. Let's go do that right now. Hey, what's up, I'm in a little kitchen. Thank you for checking out yet another video. If this is your first time here, don't hesitate to click subscribe. You'll be updated whenever I upload a new video and you'll be kept in the loop. But that is if you click that bell icon as well. You won't miss out on anything. I'm here, don't worry. You wanna see? 1, 2, 3. Told you I was here. Jon Stewart and Spin are this week's new patrons. Welcome. Patreon is connected to Discord. On Discord, it is really growing because we've got a cool community of like-minded synth nerds out there that are really like getting into the trouble that you might run into if you've got more questions than you have answers. So not only can you get in touch with me, you can get in touch with the community there and ask people questions on how to set up your sound, how to make jams, how to just focus on sounds, and you know, literally just what I do in my videos, but then extend it a lot. And since it's a global thing, every hour of the day, somebody might be online to just like chat to you, and it's cool. So thank you, and I'm very happy for that growth. As well as supporting me on Patreon would mean you help me get to the point where I'm actually developing a mixer. Now, the thing is that I'm working on that, I'm looking at that, I'm working with a few mates of mine actually. And it is so that I firmly believe that in the world of the dollars realm, it is crazy that the mixers that we use are either very expensive or very cheap, and in the end, not even cater to what it is that we do as dollars performers. So obviously everybody just buys their synths and spends like a gazillion amount on getting their synths and their samplers and the sequences to sound and look great and, you know, work it. And then all of a sudden you just end up with a small mixer that might not actually help you sound-wise. So I do think that there's lots to gain, as well as the performance aspect of it as well. So it is early days. As with COVID, it's ridiculous trying to get like parts, and we are fiddling about with a few concepts. Diode clipping, we are looking at filters, we are looking at what to use. Is it going to be high pass, band pass, low pass? How are we going to use it? What kind of filter is going to be? Gain staging, you know, it's really cool. And a very exciting process. So if you support me on Patreon, you'll be tapping into that and part of that mixer when it's done, it's gonna be yours. So thanks ever so much. So if you don't know where to go, tune in just now. patreon.com/handlelockkitchen. Going into the TB03, it is not a TB03 tutorial video. If that's what you're looking for, that's not going to be it. What it's going to be though is the way I actually come up with a pattern, tune it to the groove that I already have, and structure it so that it starts to become a catalyst in my music. Now, why do I use different catalysts? Because obviously, with that sample and hold sample pack that I've got lined up right there, it means that you, in layers, you want stuff to just do something that is not predictable. Because if you want to do a long set, if you're just doing one jam, one track, it's no problem. But I build my tracks up into different segments, and I want, as a DJ almost, I want that set to just like keep going and keep going and going, and it should take your brain somewhere else. So us human beings are very, very, well developed when it comes to just like figuring out where stuff is coming from. So after a few bars, or maybe after a minute even, you know where the frequencies are coming from. So you'll start to get like, oh, is this it? You know, and when you're not playing records or not playing with Ableton, which is what we're dollars people are not doing, not hating, just saying, you need to focus on where your live set goes in order to keep it interesting. Now, to keep it interesting would mean that even if you come up with the wickedest pattern or the wickedest sequence, it will still mean it needs to just work with something else. So what I've done is I stuck my TB03 next to the sample and hold catalyst samples, which I have got over. That it's not gonna get old. So I stuck it next to it. So I've got a beat because I'm working on a new live set. So the music is new. You've not heard this before until in a second. And then I'll just build it up. Now, what I'm always saying, and I'm going to repeat it later on, it is a game. It's like a video game. You know, you don't progress until the next level, until you completed the first one. So kick drum, maybe something that helps your kick drum grow. I think today I might even look at a tom, something that helps the groove when there's no groove at all. So instantly you go like, oh, wait a minute. Yeah, I know it, I like it. And if something breaks down, you've got something to fall back up on as well. You know, it's very important. And then you've got the drums, then you've got your bass lines. My bass lines are threefold because I use three, that's six. I use three bass line synthesizer. I use a Model D, I use a Mini Tower, and I use a TB-03. Now, they live in the same street, but what you don't want is to have them in the same house, on the same couch, or sitting on top of each other. That doesn't work. It doesn't work for the crowd. It doesn't work for the speaker. It doesn't work in the club. You sound like shh, and you know, you don't want that. So I will head over to the live set, not before I tell you that links to the equipment I'm using, it's noted in the fold below. So if you like something, those are affiliate links, mind you, need to say it. As well as if you've got certain topics that you would like me to get into, or there's questions that you have and I didn't touch upon them, or I just briefly touched them, or I just like completely flew over them, don't hesitate to leave a comment in the section below. Now, if you are ready, you on the other side of the stream, I will take you to my live set and let's see if we can make it work. You ready? Let's go. So on. All right, party people. So, okay, I guess we are recording. When it comes to the TB-03, there's a few things that I can actually do with that thing and I really love it. So the beat that I've got working today is this. Pretty simple. I've got like a tom, which is coming from the Akai MPC Live, as you can hear. So when I've got everything off, it means this is basically it. Yeah. So then I will align my kick underneath, because I do believe that that kick needs to just like be round. It needs to have a lot of texture, as I always say. So that's very important. So here we go. So, and I want something to already drive the groove. Now, I've got the sample and hold sample, which you can find in my sample and hold sample pack. It's a catalyst. What do we mean with a catalyst? What I mean with a catalyst, it means it's driving the groove. It's going in a certain direction, which means when you turn it on, the beat will get enhanced. So apart from the tom that's already playing in a certain specific frequency range, I've got like something on the octave track. Hey, before I hurry and Michelle, let me say what I've got in the box right here. So I've got the octave track connected to the Akai MPC Live. Yeah, they're all getting a MIDI signal from the multi-clock right here. Not now, but if I'm syncing other stuff up, you'll need a central clock, which in this case is my multi-clock. Those two are joined at the hip. So if I switch a sequence here, a sequence will switch here, and I've changed it up a bit, because what I've done now is actually changed up the eight sequences that I usually use for one track. I've changed it up into four. So four, the bottom row is one track, then the top, the row above is one track, track above, so that's cool. So in general, with that, the 64 pads that you have within the eight banks that the Akai is capable of, usually I set it up with the eight sequences that would mean 16 tracks. Now I can just do double that, so that's 32 tracks that I can actually utilize. And then I build it up with different sequences where different stuff is playing. For now, this is my basic pattern. So whenever I start this track, it will mean this is the first thing you hear. Yeah, so I think that you can dance to this. If this on a sound system, it will work, believe me. Now then, I've got a top loop on the octave track, because I just switch it up. Yeah, so the Akai MPC Live is doing drums and drums alone, and then, well, not drums alone, but basically it's just a glorified drum computer in the setup where I can switch out the sets. And every time when I switch to a different track, I will actually also switch out different drums. Not so much the kick drum, as you heard me say before, but I will switch out my hats or my hat patterns, or, you know, something will change. So you got the feeling that the new track is playing, but the energy and the bottom end is still there. Now, the octave track does a few things very, very interestingly. So it's a through machine for the mini tower, the Minitar, the Model D, and also for the Dave Smith Tetra. I've routed them through the four outputs so I can sum that so I don't need to bring a big ass mixer to the stage every time. Then there's an audio thing is Micro Monster over there, and then the TBO3, which we're going to focus on today. All right, so now I've got my high hat pattern on the Launch Control XL that I've got mapped to the Akai MPC Live, because on the Dave Smith Tetra, for instance, I have ruined the filter knob as well. I keep ruining knobs. Look on the Minitar, there's another knob that's ruined. So what happened is I needed to map that out. So that's cool. So I've got like my drums, the levels of the drums, I've got that mapped out on the fader section of the Launch Control XL. Above that, with the rotary knobs, I've got a filter set up with a, in this case, a sample pack that's coming from the Akai MPC Live with a Jupiter 8 sample pack on there. Very nice. New track I'm working on actually, second track in my new live set, which I will play you a bit of later. Now, I do heavily rely on my TBO3 to just work something into a groove. But the hierarchy is the kick, something to drive my kick. So in this case, it's that tom. And because I'm just too lazy to also map out that Jupiter, I just map the filter. So it's playing. But if I turn down the filter all the way, you won't hear it. Or unless you wouldn't know what to look for if I didn't tell you it was there. Now, moving on to the octatrack. Now we're going to get into this catalyst that I always talk about. A catalyst is something that drives your beat. It's the engine. It's something that sweetens up your groove. Go over to the link I will put down in the description and you will actually see all those samples there. This is one of those samples, 128 samples in my sample and hold catalyst sample pack. Ah, shameless plug. Okay, end of the plug. Now, if you are wondering, hey man, I love your samples, but isn't that you? And I want to use my own samples, or this is a catalyst that you don't have to think about, stick it in, you don't even need to mix it. Just throw it in the beat, kick from underneath, and it will work. In this case, though, to make it stand out a little bit from the basic, just like sample pack, if you really have a problem with blatantly like using stuff, I used a tom within the same key range. So, and then you can hear that all those filters are playing around in that area. And then the tom plays. So this already is playing together. Those things really like each other. Living in the same street, same neighborhood, probably neighbors. That's why they work together. Now on track 3 of the octatrack, that's 8 tracks. I'm just switched over because I don't accidentally, when I mute stuff, or you know, because sometimes if you want to do something on the fly, you just hit function, you'll hit that one that you want, the sample that you want to play in the performance mode, that is quick mute mode, or when you release it, boop, it's off. It means like more stuff can play. You see little plus signs there, which means that it's armed and ready to go. So if I want to introduce something, say maybe this, 1, 2, 3, 4. And now I introduced something else. Now this basically is the beat that I'm going to be working with today. As you can see, I've got like a 60-40 kind of division in how much drums and how much melody is in my drums. So because I want you to dance this in the end. Now at this point, this is where I'm going to introduce that TBO3. So let's stop this. I think I went over everything. Yeah, there's a TC electronic. Sometimes I just leave stuff lying about, which is not working at the moment. Micro thing is, the audio thing is Micro Monster. I need to say, and this is going out specifically to one of my patrons, namely Slim Pickens. I'm using it again. So I had a hate-love relationship with the audio thing is Micro Monster, and it's redeemed itself. So it's back on my good side. This is something that happens. Now, I'm playing the beat. But obviously, what I want to do is have everything synced up. So what I will do is I will play it from the multi-clock, as you can see here. So on channel 3. So now it's syncing this and this. So as you can see, this runs instantly. Stop, boop, stops, and plays, bam. So this one plays, that one plays. This one's got a hard time trying to figure out the first bars. You can hear the loop, but we'll figure that out. Okay, I've got hats and stuff mapped out, but we'll get to that later. First, we build it up from the bottom up. So a bit of sound design. First the kick, that's the biggest culprit in the room. We need to fix that first kick. Then the tom, that's also thick in nature. So let's put that in there as well, because if we're going to start adding bass notes, we don't want the bass notes to just like have a fight with the tom. And the tom is a very important asset here, which I didn't map out because sometimes certain things don't play. And in this case, I just want whenever I mute everything here. See, even my tom is playing, so I can make a breakdown with that TB-03. Shall we add that bad boy? I will go over to pattern 2. Why? Because the patterns I've got here correspond with the tracks I'm doing here. So track 1 would mean on my TB-03, I would choose track 1 to keep everything simple. So on track 2, which I'm playing right now, which obviously is on pad 5, 6, 7, and 8, then I will go over to pattern 2, which is not tuned up to anything, so we're going to start from scratch, right? So, I've used this pattern before, so as you can hear, it's not in key. So what I will do is, I'll turn it off. Now what I'll do, I'll go into pitch mode, and I'll go into ride mode. So you need to put this on pitch, because the original TB-303 was very hard to program. Even to this day, I don't know exactly how to do it, and it's all random what comes out. So what I want is this thing to really just like work for me, which is cool. So on pitch mode, if I'm changing the volume knob, you can see that it's going through the 16 steps. Now, if I'm not mistaken, if I press function, and I think, what was it? Or was this 16 steps? Here I've got 16 steps. So it's not that, it's the last, it's the bottom above slide. When you hold it, you get to determine how long your sequence will run for. So obviously it can be 1, 2, 3. So if you want that classic acid house kind of vibe, 3 or 5 is what basically will introduce a polymeter, which means like it keeps going, but you know. As you can hear, so in the grand scheme of things, it would play this. Also nice. But what we want is this to go. That's where we need to go, yeah? So obviously, I need to just go like, okay, let's see. So pitch mode, the first note, let's hold this one and let's go for, I will go for 8 notes, yeah? What's it playing? Yeah, because I want something as a catalyst, as I said. I want the beat to just like go a little bit faster. So if I've played drums here and that pattern gets extended a lot, which means like if I play something on the first and then something on the last bar and that pattern's 8 bars long, it means it takes a while for you to get the cycle going in your brain. And what I want is the cycle to be repetitive in that longer cycle, if that makes any sense. So what I'm going to do is play the first note. Let's find out what the key was again. That's where we go. So it's easy. So it's the number 8. Then let's, it automatically switches to the next one. So when it's in pitch mode, you basically press the note and then it will go over to the next step. So in this case, I will go up. Let's take all the slides off. There's a slide here. Okay, let's just play a simple note, note, down, note, note, double up. Yes. And then down. So now we play. Nice, right? Boring though. So we need to introduce something that is that classic kind of 303 vibe. So all those notes Nice. Now, what I'm going to do is I will start with a slide on the first of that note. When it's running, the pitch mode is not affected. So I can twist that value knob all I want. You will not hear what notes there are. But in the grand scheme of things, let's do it again. You see, now it starts to tickety. All of a sudden, my thumb is doubled up, which is not. But that frequency on the filter is at that exact same range, so your brain tells you, hey, there's another tom. Listen. That almost sounds like two toms. So we need to move that away there. So what we're going to do is the first of the notes, let's go to the second one and introduce a slide. Still. Okay, on the fourth note, I will also put a slide. Now, so between the third and the fourth note, you actually hear that that was where that sort of like double tom was playing. Listen. And we don't want that. No, we don't want that because it's going to, it's messing with my rhythm. I didn't play it that way. I don't want to. Get out of here. Get out of here. All right. Now, I think that it's staying too much in the same sort of like range. So what I will do also is, note up a little bit more. Yeah. Now, usually I use a delay on this. This time, you know, simple. Turn it off. If you hold a function, you will get into the menu of this machine. So what we will look for now, usually it's a sync. There's a lot of things that you can do. Like here you got the delay type and delay sync. And but I turned it on delay type, delay sync. But I've put it on reverb recently. Let's see if that's still working. Because I think a lot of people are using the reverb on that, so let me just like go in and just go like, you know what, let's focus on the reverb because it will work a little bit better with everything that I have. Yeah, is my philosophy on there. Now let's stop this and let's play what we have. Yeah. So if I turn it off, mind you, if it's still messing about with your tom, you can either turn it down or turn it all the way up, which means because it's spanning over three octaves, and that's the cool thing, yeah? So. For now, let's see if I can make this work. Introduce more drums. I will introduce a little bit of resonance because I still think it's eating away at my tom. We'll sort it out. So in the grand scheme of things, I don't want it. At the same time though, that tom, it's cool that it's there because if you make it drop, you'll hear something that you can actually dance to. But the thing you don't want to have happen is that constantly everybody's picking all your sounds like they're spread all over the place. So it needs to sound like it needs to sound unified. That was what I was looking for. Now, okay, what I have now, of course, I've got my drum roll here. Mute. Hats. See, instantly we're going in a certain direction. This I really like. Now, this is what I mean with the kitlist. Now, I'm not a big fan of tweaking that resonance, with all due respect. I think that DJ Pierre has done enough of that in 1985. By now, I think it's cool, and there's so many different 303s out there. What I really, really would like is for this to just stay in a certain area, which is giving myself a hard time, really, because the tom is now something that I need to rely on a lot, because I don't want to stick it in there, as you have seen, that is a problem. Now, let's see if we can introduce that sample and hold sample. One, two, three, and. Yeah, I'm digging that. I'm digging that. So for now, everything is just going like you, hugging the speaker, going crazy. Like, oh my God, finally COVID's gone. I can party. Let's stay here for 2 days. Nice. So that's exactly what it is that I'm trying to invoke on you. I will play melodies eventually. What do you? The melodies in my setup are mostly there as like, you know, the seasoning on your on the thing you're cooking. Oh man, that's a really bad analog kitchen analogy, but you know what I mean. So let's add that drum in here. Nice one. Mute. I will introduce something on my day. Smith as well. I played something with a tetra, which is also very rhythmical, but also musical, and it's going to complement this. Now, volume knobs on my synths are very important as well. On track 8 here. Here we go to a major chord. Minor. 7. I'm back. And as I said, I mapped out. Nice. So now I can make a drop. That's a reverb here as well. Reverb. So this goes through the octave track, as I said. And then I've mapped the filter on the launch control like so. Filter and also the resonance. Can you hear when you introduce more musical frequencies how all of a sudden the tom starts to just go apart from the TB-03? Funny. All of a sudden in your brain the transients start to take their own place. Kicking, here we go. So what I like about it is that the chords are changing, but the ground note is not changing. The root note is just staying exactly there where it is. Because in terms of getting your melodies to work, it's all to do with who's the boss. And in the end of the day, the TB-03, my Model D, it's got so much bass that you will see that once I introduce this. Yeah, let's go crazy. Am I? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And this is what I mean with the catalyst. So now you got two bass lines going, and you can hear that. Nice, yeah? Because the thing is, I want you to forget about that is playing until I would turn it off. See? Now you miss it. When it's not there, you actually miss it. But if I'm going to start to... And I'm entering sounds with the multi-clock, because then I can actually just like hit it, trigger it, and it will start playing in the beat, which is very important. So. Low end, mute. I've opened the filter on the TB-03 a little bit. Let's turn it up also a little bit on my mixer. And what I'm going to do is introduce that Jupiter 8 sound. Love that resonance. This is my Stranger Things crazy post-COVID kind of vibe. Or whatever. Follow the T-Birthday. 2, 3, 4. So that's how you introduce the music. If I go back and if I want to just like go back to my TB-03, because nobody's focusing on a TB-03 at the moment. It's playing, you know it's there, but you're not focusing on it. So what I will do is hidden in plain sight, as I'll call it. I'll lower the filter slightly. And now start to take stuff out. Filter down. Now listen to this. Now we go back to groove. Instantly we've got a drop. I'm only working with the one pattern. Obviously, if I'm just making this into a live setup, I will copy those patterns over and just add stuff and take stuff out so that I got a little bit more interesting stuff that will happen. But for this tutorial, obviously, I want something to actually metabolize in a way that it will just go. Now I can literally stop yourself. What I can do is add more sequences, but the trick to doing a live set that will work and to get results fast, actually, in my opinion, is to really focus on what does what. And I look at it as a band, I keep saying it. I look at this stuff as a band. There's much more that is playing. There's a lot more that I can do. But for in this case, my TB-03, if it doesn't play, it doesn't really work for my kind of vibe. And the crazy thing that I believe is very important is it's like a game almost, like a video game. So I don't progress onto the next level if I didn't complete the one level that I think like, okay, I need to really like focus on this, which is like I told you, if I'm turning the stuff off that was playing, this goes down. I'll turn this off as well, which means on track 6, 7, and 8 is what I told you, they smith the Model D and the Mini Tower. The Mini Tower is also playing something, which is playing this, I think. Check out how this is going to be. There's a bit of a rolling delay on there. And then you level it out. You level stuff out to see like, okay, is it working? Yes or no? Bassline here. But as you can hear, you can stick this underneath everything. So the kick is there and that's punchy. There's a lot of transients attack on the kick, which is absolutely amazing. But this goes on top of the kick. Then on top of that goes this. And in between, that's where you try and squeeze in the TB-03. So you don't have to worry about, oh, my sounds, because you need to have this whole thing sound as a whole, right? That's what you want. Okay. Shall I add some drums? Yes, I can. Bam! Kick you in the face. Oh, so hit like and subscribe, by the way, if you have not done so already. If you like this sample. Nice. And in order to think about, it's just 2 in the afternoon or 3 in the afternoon on a festival, this is a nice flow to play. Then again, if it's 4 in the morning and everybody's looking at you crazy, then this is the vibe. So I love to just like work the filters. Mind you, just because you have them doesn't mean you need to just like show everyone that you have them. So everything in moderation is what I will always suggest. Hey, I guess that's that. Let me jam it out for you. My drum roll. long release. Also, there's different things you can do with the TB-03. That's just the way I use it. That's the way I utilize it. I don't want my boxes to be too difficult to work with. They need to just be very simple and intuitive, because I need for this to just like work for me, not against me. And that's a gazillion things you can do. In this case, that's how I stack it up. So for me, this sort of like these movies I'm doing are all about, you know, how do I layer stuff up? How do I get things to work together? Because different brands have different characters. If you don't know what you're doing, it all sounds like a hodgepodge of not something not going in the right direction. So this is that. If you made it this far into the video, oh my God, thank you very much. I guess after the video, we're going to have a video after party, which means like, if you follow me on Patreon, you can get into Discord. And on Discord, a lot of like-minded folks, synthesizer guys, are actually helping each other out. And it's cool. Find the gems on Bandcamp. That's where I just stick the gems if I like them. Now, I'm just one of those musicians, you know what I mean? It's not like I'm insecure, but at the same time, I'm not the most secure guy when it comes to, I need to like it. Sometimes I don't, sometimes I do. So if I'm picky, I would just want to set a high standard. So if the jams turn out well for the video, they might not turn out well as a track to play per se. And especially with those new tracks, I'm a bit checking out. So I've got a bit of a lag, and so there's a few tracks that I still need to chop up, because obviously the track 20 minutes long, I'm not going to stick that on Bandcamp. But it's coming. Stay tuned. There's more music than you might think, and there's also a lot of music that I've never released. I need to go through the hard disk and find. Did he say hard disk? He did. I need to just go and find out what tracks I have lying about, what I can actually give you. So that is that. Links to the equipment, note and fold below. Don't hesitate to just leave a comment. Don't be a stranger, and hit that subscribe button if you didn't do that, and just hit that bell as well, so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. The last thing I'm going to tell you is that you can support the vibe, the flow, the flavor, the flow on patreon.com, where I'm actually developing a few things, making better content for you. That's one. Developing a mixer in the end also for you. That is something else we're doing. And the cool part is that Patreon is connected to Discord, and Discord, that's where all like-minded people are just like getting together. So if you get into the higher tiers on Patreon, the higher tiers, it's not breaking the bank, mind you. But if you get into the higher tiers, the highest tier is just me getting on one-on-ones with you, telling you how you should improve or can improve your music, what to do, what not to do, how to utilize sounds, how to listen to sounds. That's the highest Patreon tier. And the tier below that is just like, you know, me also getting in touch, but then on a more global level with a lot of people. And also, go and grab that catalyst. Go and grab that sample and hold catalyst. You're going to like it. It's going to help you out a lot, because if you can't get your groove started, those are excellent track starters. Now, did I plug myself enough? I guess so. Will you see me next week on another video? You betcha. Peace.